Hello, everybody. We are playing Hitman 3, the new Escalation that was just released. So we're gonna give it a go. As you see, we had to have everybody killed by an accident, so we're gonna see how this goes. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, anything helps. And I'll see you next time. Enjoy the video.
Private area, sir.
Phineas Whitmark, private investigator. I have an appointment with Madame Carlyle. Please wait.
Mr. Whitmer is here to see Madame Carlyle. You can go right in.
A bit excessive. I mean, considering the fact that I spotted no less than two routes to get inside the house unseen.
We know what we're doing, sir. Don't worry about that.
Mr. Whitmer, thank you for coming on such short notice. A great tragedy has fallen upon us, and I need a quick resolution, handled with absolute discretion.
Results and discretion are my specialty.
Very well. I suppose you will want to start at the crime scene.
In my experience, a thorough examination of a potential crime scene is half the job done.
Good. Fernsby will take over from here.
I am Mr. Fernsby, the butler. Madame Carlyle has asked me to assist you in any way possible. Mr. Whitmer, I understand that you've traveled from London. Would you care for some refreshments, or do you prefer to go straight to Mr. Zachary's sleeping quarters?
I prefer to get started.
As you wish. If you'll follow me, sir. I feel obliged to point out that current affairs surrounding Madame Carlyle are of a delicate nature. You may be familiar with the recent announcement of her death. You will probably learn that a staged funeral is scheduled to take place tomorrow. Madame's children were not informed until this morning that their mother was in fact not dead at all. So please bear with
Hello, sir.
If they seem affected by the rather unusual situation. I trust I do not need to remind you that there will be consequences if word gets out that Madame Carlyle is still alive.
I'll consider her dead when I leave.
Before you inspect the crime scene, I will tell you this. The case concerns the death of Mr. Zachary, Madame Carlyle's younger brother. He was found dead in his bed this morning. The door was locked from the inside, and a suicide letter was found in his room. However, Madame Carlyle suspects foul play and will not accept that he took his own life. I've prepared some information for you, so please do come and see me when you've finished your investigation of the crime scene. This is Mr. Zachary's room, to my right.
Stop pacing, for God's sake, Emma.
But why don't we get any kind of explanation? It's bloody rude, that's what it is. Making us come here to play funeral and then show up like nothing's the least bit strange.
Well, don't get your knickers all twisted.
I'm telling you, she's not fit to be in charge anymore.
Listen, Gregory, something's off. Pruitt got word his motion was rejected. We all signed the bloody thing 4 days ago.
Oh, dear God, not this again.
What?
So I got hold of the officer.
Oh, bugger.
He said it was
That looks
luck.
Broken.
Then how can it be withdrawn?
Just wait a few days. I'm sure it'll sort itself out.
Well, that's properly fouled up.
Can't you just relax for a minute?
And that solicitor upstairs. Why do you think he's here?
I think solicitors are mother's favorite kind of people. Can't remember ever. Oh, crap! Come on. Yeah, they've been some kind of accident. I don't know. It doesn't look good.
didn't I? This freakiest accident.
That American lawyer in the small office, did you check his travel documents?
I did, sir. It all checked out.
Step back and let me deal with it.
Looks like we've got an accident on our hands.
You don't have to say that again.
Ah, crap.
Just in case. Leave it to me.
Did you talk to Mother?
I haven't had the pleasure.
She just clams up when I try to get an explanation. Not even an apology. I mean, believing I'm on the jail, that's how I'm like.
Yeah, keep it real.
God awful, boring.
You there, wait!
Stop, right now!
Look, I don't buy the get up.
I will find someone who's gonna teach you some manners.
Sierra 6 reporting in. We've got a definite...
Obviously, it's all a major cock-up. The first I've ever seen from our perfect mother. Finally, something amusing happens in this god-awful bore of the family. Why not lean back and enjoy the spectacle?
Bill! This'll be good.
What the hell's going on?
Where's Mother? She called for a meeting, right?
She's not here, so...
that out.
No problem.
We're clear. There's nothing here.
I could listen all day. He poured emotion into that.
Right down here. Stand by while I investigate.
What the hell, man?
Here we go again.
This is torture. I need time to focus on the eulogy.
How's everything coming along?
Very well, Mr. Burke.
I need to stop thinking about Emma all the time, but she just makes me so angry.
Tell me.
Elaine says she saw her on the top floor, stroking the door to Alexa's office. I kid you not.
I saw her rearranging the photos in the sitting room, hiding Madame in the back, and then moving Montgomery to the front. She's not right in her head. Why would she do that? He died almost 50 years ago.
Rebecca, do you see this about old Wampy?
He is fancier than me.
Maybe you can get an exclusive for one of your papers.
I saw. I didn't think I'd be able to pay much, though.
Excuse me, but who are you again?
Sir, you should stop right now.
You can't walk away from me.
No. No! I am a man.
place. You need to leave now. It's for your own safety.
This will be over in a minute.
Okay, that's it. Stay right there.
Painkillers. Lethal if you use enough of them.
Come have a drink with me, sis. I can give you some advice on how to relax. Looks like you need it.
I have more important things to do. You know, you should really check up with your own financial affairs to make sure they're not affected by this whole mess.
Let's agree to disagree on that one, Rebecca.
Arrived at location and it looks clear. Over.
How are things coming along inside? Is everything ready for tomorrow?
I can't deal with all this pretend funeral stuff just now. I know I have to, but Amy thinks she might be pregnant. I'm gonna be a dad.
You'll be fine, Robbie.
tell you what Emma did when she arrived.
What is it now?
She scolded Mary for not making the bed the way she preferred. It's so unfair.
What?
Like that, I bet you've worked with a lot of high-profile celebrities. I'd much rather hear your story. See, I can't imagine you've got to go behind closed doors in a house like this. I'm sure.
You almost got me.
you know, I told Patrick off. I'm not interested. Hey, what are you? Rosie thinks she's in love with young Pat.
Excuse me?
Mister, you are going down for this. That's first degree murder.
Got to
bring you down.
I have to be a bit more specific. We'll be right back.